are delighted to have all of you here seated with us today, celebrating this wonderful moment. Just before we start, I would like to tell you a little bit about the brand. So we started way back in 1934 as a film development company. We were producers of films. However, today, in 2019, we stand as a giant corporation which has created its own market in various industries, not just imaging solutions, but healthcare, material solutions, document solutions, and many, many more. The one thing which has remained constant with Fujifilm over the years is our constant contribution to the advancement. Advancement, I'm talking of science, of culture, of technology, of improvised health, now that I've just mentioned that we've also ventured into the healthcare category, and towards environmental protection. You can say that is our way of giving back to the society. And the one of the main cornerstones which has helped us in achieving this goal, this objective, is the fact that we can't tell you the amount of emphasis we give to innovation. Because it is only innovation which will bring forth solutions to what may seem as impossible problems right now. Agree? Do we all agree? I think we have... are you all hungry? Was the breakfast not good? Yeah? Okay. So I'm not going to bore you anymore because we have some dignitaries who've joined us here today. We've got our senior management which has come all the way from Japan to be a part of this very, very, very special occasion. So without any further ado, I'm going to introduce all of them to all of you. I'm going to request everybody to please welcome all of them with a round of applause. We have with us, yes, our General Manager, Optical Device and Electronic Imaging Japan, Toshi-san. We also have with us our Managing Director, Fujifilm India, Iwata-san. Can we hear it for them, please? Manager, Sales and Marketing Group, Optical Division and Electronic Imaging Japan, Makoto-san. Divisional Head, Optical Device and Electronic Imaging, So-san. Senior Manager, Fujifilm India, Optical Device and Electronic Imaging, Zenko-san. Regional Marketing Advisor, Asia Pacific Electronic Imaging, Nakata-san. Senior Vice President, Optical Device, Electronic Imaging and Fujifilm India, Ram-san. And National Marketing Manager, Optical Device and Electronic Imaging, Fujifilm India, Arun-san. All right, so now that I've introduced our dignitaries to all of you, it's time to start with the proceedings officially. And to formally welcome all of you, I'm going to once again welcome on stage our Managing Director, Fujifilm India. Sir, can I please have you on stage? Can we welcome, sir, with a big hand?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Haruto Iwata, Managing Director of Fujifilm India. First of all, I would like to thank all of you for taking time off to attend this launch event, World First 100 Megapixel Large Format Mirrorless Camera, GFX100, and Fujinon Lens Premista. It has been a year since we launched our GFX50S here at Mumbai. And since then, we have increased our GFX lineup with two cameras, 50S and 50R, and 8 GFX lenses. Also, this is first time ever we are introducing in India Fujinon lens for a cinema camera named Premista. Today, I'm so proud to invite the world-class photographer for today's event. Let me introduce them in briefly. First, Indian top celebrity and fashion photographer and Fujifilm X series brand ambassador, Mr. Daboo-san. Thank you, Daboo-san. And next, US top photographer and X series brand global ambassador, Mr. Zack, Arias-san. they celebrate, these top celebrities will share their impression and experience with Fujifilm new products later. And from Fujifilm Tokyo, Tokyo headquarters, General Manager Mr. Toshi Iida and Product Planning Manager Mr. Makoto Oishi are attending to share the worldwide global reaction of the new products and product concept. Last year, I told you three main subjects. First one, we develop Fujifilm unique products and the get the sales growth. Launch 6 products last year and we grow. And second point, we accelerate to expand the touch point like workshop opportunities. We expand the Pan-India Field Service Center, service network. As a result of financial year 2018, we got triple times of sales and more than 100 workshops and 8 service center and over 100 collection points are operational. It means we can achieve them perfectly. Thank you very much. But I'm not satisfied yet. So I must tell you more for this year, 2019. First one, we increase sales at least double. And we set up over 600 workshops. Third one, and we will plan to set one more service center in Cochin. And we will expand over 150 collection points till 2020. And also, in future, we would like to develop the special featuring camera with unique color reproduction for Indian market requirement. Now, the market of digital camera is going down due to smartphone expansion as a worldwide market. We think the market of digital camera is going down if there is nothing of attractive product will be developed. But if fantastic products are developed and launched, the market will be changed. And we create market by more unique camera with cutting edge technology. Especially, I believe there is unlimited possibility as a mirrorless camera and lens in this Indian market. Also, I have duly told you, Fujifilm India has entered the Indian camera cinema lens market to contribute making the Indian market more active. Today's product, GFX100 and Premister, are the flagship model with Fujifilm highest technologies. I would like to all of you to touch them and feel the advantage of our products. We Fujifilm never stop. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much, sir. So ladies and gentlemen, as we move forward, it's time to highlight a little bit about the series which is going to be continuing forward today. GFX series is something everybody here is familiar with. It is a one-of-a-kind mirrorless large format camera. And we're taking this legacy forward by introducing something which has never happened in the market before. I have been told that, you know, there are megapixel cameras of, there are cameras of much lower megapixel available in the market. However, this is the first time somebody in the entire market, not just in the Fujifilm brand, has come up with a fantastic new camera with a 100 megapixel. So I'm sure everybody sitting here can understand the kind of image quality that this camera is going to deliver. So without telling you anything further, it's time to have a look at the AV. I'm going to request everybody to look towards the screen. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the all-new GFX 100. I think everybody can understand that the kind of image quality that this camera would deliver is what we, in our millennial terms, call next level. Yes? We have one more new product which we are launching. It's a brand new baby from the house of Fujifilm. It's a fantastic lens. I'm sure everybody knows the name. It's the Premista. It's time to now take your cinematic experience to another level. Once again, we're going to start with watching an AV first. Can we have the AV on screen, please? Fantastic jewels from the house of Fujifilm have just been brought in front of all of you. Can we please give the GFX 100 and Premista one more big hand? Can we do that? Thank you very much. So now you've seen a glimpse of the same, but it's time to see the product live right here on stage. And to bring it forward in front of all of us, I'm going to request our management team to please join me back. Can we have all of you joining us back on stage? Requesting Toshi-san, Iwata-san, Makoto-san, So-san, Zenko-san, Nakata-san, Ram-san, and Arun-san to join us. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to bring the beauties on stage in style. Requesting everybody to look to their right. Team right here. How does it feel holding these beauties in your hand? Does it feel fantastic? Very light. That's a very good quality. Very light, very portable, very easy to carry around. Okay, just a request to all of you. I think we can continue the photo session after a little time. We need to continue with the product presentation. Thank you so much, gentlemen, for joining me on stage. So-san, I'm going to request you to remain on stage for the product presentation. Toshi-san? Okay. Ladies, thank you for joining me on stage. Thank you very much. It's time to shed some more light on these wonderful products, and we have Toshi-san on stage with us. Over to you, sir.
Check, check, check. Can you hear me? Okay, okay. So now, time to start. I was supposed to say good morning, but actually, good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. It's my honor and privilege and big honor to be here with you. Very important Indian photographers and the DOPs, as well as media partners. So today, I'm glad to show you two revolutionary new products, GX100 and the Premista, which is a large format, the cinema lens. Then, yeah. Okay, so those two revolutionary products, it's the theme is living large. So large format, the cameras, and the lenses opened up the new horizon for photos and videos. So before I start showing the detail of the products, I'd like to briefly touch on our technologies, our core competence. So what Fujifilm and Fujinon can do for photos and the video in the future. The first, optical. So Fujifilm has been established since 1934, but only 6 years after the establishment, we already started the glass development as well as manufacturing. So we have a 79 years experience in the optical and the glasses. So today I brought the one lens here. So let me have a grab. So you know what this glass is made for. It's a huge glass. Its diameter is 20 centimeters. So this is actually the front lens of broadcasting lens. So this is a 4K, 107 times zoom. So this shooting the cricket games or a big concert. So this is a big glass, 20 centimeters diameter lens. Is used for this the lens. And if you look at the surface of this glass, have to be very smooth and pretty much accurate. So how much the super smooth this glass is for 4K and 8K? The tolerance is 30 nanometers, so 0.00003 millimeters on top of 200 millimeters. Would you imagine how small this tolerance is? I explain this way. Here we are in the Mumbai, okay? Can you imagine this entire glass is all throughout India, 603 square kilometers. So how much tolerance? How small on top of entire Mumbai? Its acceptance tolerance is 2.1 millimeter. So if you find that anything 2.1 millimeter entire Mumbai, so this lens is not qualified. That is a 30 nanos on top of 200 millimeter. Can you follow me? So 2.1 millimeter is this thickness of SD card. Okay, so if you find this thickness SD card somewhere in the Mumbai, that lens is not qualified to be 4K and 8K. So that is a brilliant lens polishing technology we have. And the one lens is okay. The problem is this 4K 107 times zoom lens. Inside of this lens, 40 glasses, individual lens element, that's sitting in the, this one box lens, right? What problem we have? Because each lens has a reflection. When the light comes to the lens, you will lose 4%. Before it goes through the lens, you will lose another 4%. So one lens will eat 8% of the light, 92. One lens is okay. What happened? 40 lenses. You will end up only 3.6% of the light goes through 40 lenses. Very dark light you can get. Instead, luckily enough, we have a coating technology, HT-EBC, Fujifilm, and we have a nano-GI coating technologies. Those technologies will minimize, actually reduce down to 1/10, 0.4% and 0.4%. So instead of 0.92, the lens, 99.2% lens will come through one lens, but still 40 lenses, 72.5% light go through 40 lenses. So thanks to those super coating technologies, we get the 20 times more light than without coating. So this is one example of our Fujifilm optical technologies. So these technologies help us to develop various optical fields. You saw 4K, 8K. We are leading the 4K, 8Ks. Only two companies can do, Fuji and the Canon. But we are well ahead of 4K, 8K broadcasting field. Today, we are introducing the large format cinema lens. So many Hollywood DOPs are using Fujifilm cinema lens. And here is the Bollywood DOPs start taking shooting with Fujifilm zoom lenses. On contrary, we are marketing also the endoscope. Endoscope requires a very small lens instead. So actually 0.5 millimeter lens, we are still polishing. So only Fuji can polish such a small lens up to the, such a big glass. So on the gallery, you will see our brand new projector. So Fujifilm is now developing the ultra short throw projector. Very limited small space, you can throw the big display. You will see on the gallery, please. So the projector called the Z5000 will be introduced shortly in the India too. We are biggest supplier to the prism, to the broadcasting cameras and the medical cameras. And quite shortly, we are introducing ultra long zoom security cameras. So this camera can capture the numbers of the car 3 kilometers from distance. So this is a super long zoom surveillance cameras. And of course, XF and the GF lenses are incorporated, they fully incorporated all those Fujifilm technologies. So let's move on to color science. So everybody understand Fujifilm is a company who've been passionate about image quality, especially for color reproduction. It's not only for still photography. Now we are focusing on the more movie and the video quality. So here I have a short movie, right? And that's four cameras being tested in the same lighting condition, same models, side by side, four cameras. One of those are X-T3, three of those, the other brand, in the same class. Please have a movie first. So you see the skin tone. This is a brand A. This is the other camera, second camera. Please remember A, B, C. This is B. And third camera, the C. That's D, the last one. The same model, same lighting condition, same everything, just a different cameras. And bear in mind, these images, the movies, came straight out of the cameras. No color grading, no post-edition at all. So A, B, C, D. So can I ask you, so which colors, which skin tone, your favorite? Starting D, B, C, A. Thank you very much. A is X-T3. Right, so this is straight out of the cameras without any post-editing. So for X-T3, we got Eterna mode. Eterna is a legendary film for cinemas. And when we introduced XH1, so we introduced this new as a new film cinemas, film simulation mode. It's called Eterna. And GFX100 has got same film look simulation mode. So let's move on to the product detail. So today, we are introducing you the large format cameras and the large format the lenses for cinemas. Let's start with the GX100. Okay. So this is a format of 35 millimeters. So actually, here's the sensor, 35 millimeter sensor. Okay. And we are calling this the full frame. Here's my question. Are you full with full frame? So this full frame, the diagonal is 43 millimeter. Okay. Now, we have a sensor, which is 70% the larger size, has a 55 millimeter diagonal instead of the 43. So this is a sensor for GFX. And now this sensor is upgraded to 100 megapixels. But strange enough, we're still calling this format the medium format. So while small format says full frame, why we're sticking to the name of the medium format, like old film days? We are living in the modern digital age. So our suggestion is, let's call it large format in modern digital time with a fat 55 millimeter big diagonal. So this is the new large format sensor in the digital era. So we introduced February 2017, first generation of GX50S. Since we introduced, this is the global shipment number. So it's just kept growing. And particularly after the, we introduced the 50L, the small, much more affordable 50 megapixel cameras, the sales been picked up dramatically and still carry on. And those GF lenses, the following the body numbers. So today, we are introducing GX100. So this will make our GF system up to the next level. And we already, other countries already started the selling GX100, and the initial order is incredibly high, probably more than twice as many as we expected. So I hope here in India, so GX100 will be very popular among professionals and keen amateurs. So GX100, here's a short list of the specifications, but I don't want to go through one by one today. Telling you, when we announced the GX100, back in last year at Fotokina development announcement, some people said 100 megapixel is a kind of overkill, it's too many, too much, but why are you introducing 100 megapixel? We're not just playing the numbers or megapixels alone. 100 megapixel cameras. Is this a camera to preserve very important things for the future? So I'm just touching on what is the mission of photography. We are taking the photography. What is the real mission of the photography? This is a French thinker, Roland Barthes. It said, photography is kind of that has been, related to the that has been. So by being photographed, so all precise moment, precious things will become that has been. It's kept in the memory. So mission of the photography is to preserve that has been, anything happening now for the future. What's happening? For example, the nature, right? We have a beautiful landscape and beautiful animals. However, because of the global warming or environmental destructions, so beautiful landscape and endangered animals are disappearing somewhere in the globe. We have many events, social events, sports events. Those things have to be preserved. And the human, of course. So I think now our living room, we got a 4K movie, 4K TVs, and we have a brilliant printing technology now. So 20 years ago, who imagined we got a 4K monitors at the home? Now we are talking about 8K. The same things may happen 10 years, 20 years later. So what kind of the displaying device, what kind of the printing technologies are waiting for us? For those time, we need to keep the current precious moment as highest possible megapixel or highest possible recording data. We cannot look back 20 years later. So GX100 are developed to preserve many important things for the future. So let's have a look at the image quality. Of course, that image quality comes from brand new image sensor. This image sensor is not something we packed many, many megapixels. The structure itself is completely different, something revolutionary. So here is a traditional sensor. It's typically aluminum wiring sandwiched between micro lens top and the bottom is photodiode. So all the light have to come through the micro lens, through the very small aluminum wiring, the space, and finally reach to the photodiode. So the evolution of GFX100 sensor is first the reverse wiring and the photodiode. So thanks to this backside illumination structure, the light comes through the micro lens, directly coming into the photodiode. So you can collect much more light than before. Second innovation is make aluminum the copper. The beauty of the copper is data transfer speed. Okay? The copper transfer at least 60% the faster than the aluminum. The first data transfer is two benefits. One is you can minimize the noise. The second is you can transfer the data very, very fast. That will help autofocus speed and the 4K movie capabilities. So GX100, the world's first in large format, a backside illumination, and copper wiring. Thanks to this, yeah, like this. So thanks to this, the sensor, image quality is stunning. So later on, you will see the, you know, on the gallery to see the physical prints. But on the screen, I'd like to show the one example. The seeing is believing. This was taken by GX100, right? The quality is fantastic. You see the, all the detail of the rocks, and you still get the, you know, very detail of the shadow. The quality is good. However, this is only a small part of 100 megapixel. Actually, it has only 2 megapixel portion of 100 megapixel. So let's have a look, entire frame. So this is the power of 100 megapixel, okay? So your clients may ask you, I want to crop, I want to edit this. Don't worry, 100 pixels. You can, you know, the zoom and the crop at any point. Maybe you want to, me to go back again. 2 megapixel, okay? 100 megapixel. It's, we are amazed by seeing this picture. More megapixel sometimes means more noise, right? Because on the sensor, it's big, but still limited, the many pixels. Sometimes, you know, bad news is, you know, sacrificing ISO sensitivity. But thanks to large format, the GX100 can go up to over 100,000 ISOs with very acceptable noise. Dynamic range is one of the strengths of GX100. This under the backlit condition. Dynamic range can go up to 14 stop, and many photographers requested us, why not 16-bit output? So GX100 has got 16-bit. So image quality is pretty much promising, right? So many photographers has perception. The traditional medium format, now we're calling large format, but the medium format cameras is slow. That perception is blown away by GX100. It's fast readout sensor together with very powerful processor, X processor 4. It is can process almost 1 gigabyte per second information. The data is processed. So what this means for the photographers? First thing is autofocus. So medium format is very slow autofocus. But that will become the history once you touch the GX100. Thanks to the face detections and the autofocus speed, 0.05 seconds. It's super fast. So you feel exactly like, you know, traditional SLRs, or even faster, or even more accurate by having this face detection sensor. And the latest face and eye detection technologies, which we introduced, XT3, XT30, is fully incorporated to the GX100. Detecting the face and the eyes very fast, very accurate, and the tracking. You won't be worried about the low light condition. Because of that sensor and that powerful processors, you can focus in the low light condition up to the -2 EV. So real breakthrough of GFX100. Is in body stabilization. So this is in body stabilization. So it's big IBIS unit, so built in the cameras, okay? So this will work perfectly 5 axis up to the 5.5 stop. So even I can go down to the 1/8 shutter speed without noticing the any blur. So 5.5 stops, brilliant IBIS technologies. The challenge to our R&D team to have this technology is the sensor surface alignment, okay? So this sensor is sitting in the cameras. The light comes straight to straight from the lens, and that light have to be keep the straight to the sensor throughout this big sensor, okay? If the sensor is a little bit tilting, right, you will lose 100 megapixel resolution. So this sensor have to be stay the straight within the sensor. And the tolerance for those is 20 micrometers out of 55 millimeter diagonal, 0.04%. So which means if this sensor tilting over 0.04% slightly, you cannot get 100 megapixel, right? So our factory is 100% make sure that this sensor is to stay aligned, it's straight within the camera. That is a brilliant engineering. So let's see how it works, right? Very challenging condition. So the shooting from the helicopter, right? Vibration, everything, but the shooting by handheld. So what he shot is this image. Zooming, pretty much sharp, right? So would you believe this picture's been taken from the helicopter with a big vibration? So that's handheld shooting for large format cameras can be realized only by this the strong IBIS unit, okay? So of course, the sensor processor is not just, is not everything you can get 100 megapixel. Before sensor and processor, you need decent quality of lenses. Our GF lenses originally designed to be incorporated to over 100 megapixels. When we introduced the GFX 50S, we started the three lenses. We never stopped developing. So now it's getting mature and mature. So now we have nine lenses. Don't worry, you will get more. So this is the current lineup. They're covering pretty much every single important focal length. So now, quite shortly, we are introducing a new 50 f/3.5. So this lens is very lightweight, only 335 grams. Especially together with 50R, total weight is just over 1 kilogram. So this will become the world's lightest large format camera and lens combo. You still get 100 megapixel resolution with this lens. So next lens is coming is medium range, the zoom lens, 45 to 100. Together with 30 to 64, 100 to 200, which we already introduced, together with the 45-100, our GF zoom lens, the covering from 32 to 200, three lenses. Okay, so let's move on to the premisa. This is a large format, the cinema lens. Two lenses, 20 to 100, 80 to 250. Sorry, you have looked, but I know. It's worth you look again. Make it a little wider. So six focal lengths of the primes. is packed into one zoom, covering 28 to 100. So why are we calling Premista? Okay. So this is our current the cine zoom lens. They call the Premier series. They're covering the Super 35. So this lens is very popular among the Hollywood and the Bollywood DOPs that start taking shooting with this lens. The similar focal length, but then covering the much bigger image circle, 46.3, the actually is, you know, covering the Vista Vision image circle. So Premier plus Vista Visions, then we call it Premista. Although covering the, you know, much, much larger image circle, it's 28% shorter than the Premier series. And if you look at the weight, it's almost half. Very lightweight, the compact zoom to cover large format, Vista Vision. So we are introducing two Premista lens. The first is 28 to 100, and 80 to 250, the telezoom will follow the later this year. In terms of T-stop, 28 to 100 is a 2.9 flat, and 80 to 250, starting at 2.9 up to 200 millimeter, then the slightly ramping down. Premista covers all those cameras, so-called the large format, except the Lexa 65. It covers a 46.3 millimeter. It's amazing. The Fujinon, the zoom lens, it became already very famous among Hollywood, and we hope this will become the famous for Bollywood here. So these are the credits and the titles. Small example, so which titles the with Fujinon cine lens are used to shot on. The beauty of the zoom lens, right? Why Fuji is not introducing a prime lens? Why we are focusing on the zoom lens? Zoom lens is give you versatility. In any conditions, you cannot change the lens. The one zoom lens, you can be very flexibility. Versatility. Okay. Here, I want you to show the one short movie. It's a behind the scene. It came from our dark room in our factory.
私たちが丹精込めて作り上げたこのレンズで撮影した映画を早く世界中の皆さんに見ていただきたい、そう思っております。
So we have technologies, R&D technologies, but without having a skillful, passionate, the craftsman, these lenses cannot be realized. So many process, manufacturing process, done by human beings, and they are skillful, trained many, many years. So this is the premise that was born by combining together Fujinon's latest technology and fantastic craftsmanship. Polishing, like you saw on the big lens, the coating, as I explained, and this is a glass aspherical lens. To make the, you know, the cine lens small, we need the special spherical shaped the lens. So here is a premistas, the lens constructions, right? About 30 lenses sitting in the premistas. So today I brought the one front lens. So this is a very special shaped spherical lens. As you saw, this was the grinding by hand, okay, to make this big spherical lens. So that is the secret of the premistas, how we can make the small, how we can maintain the, you know, the fantastic quality to get a large image circle. And finally, assembling without tilting or perfect alignment. Okay. So what happened if GFX 100 and premistas are married together? GFX 100 is fantastic still photographic camera as well as fantastic the movie recording cameras. So 4K 4.22 10-bit output. This is the world's first large format mirrorless camera. So let's have a look at the making scenes. So actually, this is a Super 35. Traditionally, we shoot. This is, you are talking about large format in the cinemas, 35 millimeters DCI and GFX. You don't have to crop. You still get, you know, the full size for 4K DCI. So let's have a look for making a movie first. So we selected a very challenging the lighting conditions to see the dynamic range, skin tone, depth of field. It's a very small setting like this, right? So next, let's have a look, outcome result. You see the noise, the skin tone, shadow detail, highlight detail, depth of field. All three look quality. You hardly see rolling distortion as well. So that's movies came from GFX 100 together with premistas. Low noise, wide dynamic range, and very beautifully smooth skin tone. He's a director of this film. He said, large format mirrorless, open new horizon of 4K digital cinema. So this is my end of slide. So these two cameras at the lens is something happening revolutionary in the photography and the movie industry. And we will keep our innovation to make the whole industry excited and helping photographers and the DOPs shoot fantastic quality of the still and the movies. Thank you very much.
Check. Thank you very much, Toshi-san, for shedding so much of light on the features of both these products. As we move forward, we have a couple of very acclaimed photographers seated amongst us who have not only tried and tested, but approved the all-new Fujifilm GFX100. Before I welcome them on stage, I'm going to make a request to all those of you seated in the audience. If you're going to be putting up any content on social media, especially on Facebook and Instagram, please don't forget to tag us. You can tag it with hashtag Revolution100 @FujifilmXIndia. Can we do that? For anybody who's putting any kind of content, whether you're writing something or putting pictures or videos, please, please don't forget to tag us. Our tag is #Revolution100 and @FujifilmXIndia. So as we move forward, it's time now for me to welcome on stage our very first photographer, who now is not only a very, very celebrated, acclaimed, and India's most loved celebrity and fashion photographer, but he is also our Fujifilm GFX brand ambassador. Without any further ado, I am now going to welcome on stage Mr. Daboo Ratnani.
Thank you for having me, Fuji. Thank you, Fujifilm, for all this. This was a brief introduction of the kind of work that I do. So you know the kind of action, the kind of movement, the kind of speed that we require, you know, when we are shooting, especially with celebrities, when we're shooting with, you know, models, fashion. My constant, you know, worry was speed, when you're, especially when it's such a large format camera. You know, so this has taken care of everything for me. I mean, this is a first hand. I've done it myself. I've shot for it. All the features, you all have already heard about all the stories and all the features that are, you know, associated with this camera. But it's absolutely true, and I vouch for that, you know, because leaving a DSLR and moving to mirrorless was one big move for me. But honestly, since I've got the Fuji system with me, I've never even opened my DSLR bag again. You know, I mean, it's, I've never found the need for that because there's so much. First of all, I love technology. I love tech. I love, you know, when I was one of the first few photographers that moved to digital way back in, I think, 2003 or 2004. And at that time, people were very scared, you know, okay, you know, should we leave film? You know, it's not, it's a phase. Is it going to be something that is just going to die out really soon? Is it going to be, you know, and so people are so used to shooting film at that time. But I thought that this is the future. Once I saw, you know, when it reached a 22 megapixel kind of a zone, I thought, oh, this is it. You know, I mean, it's, I was preferring it to shooting film. But we honestly missed the film look. You know, we all shot Provia, we shot Velvia, we shot lots of Fujifilm back in the day. So I'm really glad that, you know, using Fujifilm has given me those film looks back. And it's not only in the JPEGs which the camera produces, even in the Capture One software that I use, those same curves have been incorporated in the Capture One in the raw processing software, you know. So I'm really glad to have, you know, get that back, the film look that I used to get earlier. And the feel of this camera was something that I absolutely loved. You know, the minute it came in my hand, it feels no more heavier than a DSLR, but gives you 100 megapixel. I was also in that thought process before this came that, you know, 36 megapixel is more than enough. We already have it. But after using this and using the images, and like he said, you know, how people crop images, especially when we are shooting film publicity, when we are shooting campaigns, you know, there's very less time with the actors. So many times they'll say, the agency guy will say, mid shots le lo, we'll crop it later. Or full length le lo, we'll make it mid shots later. I mean, we tried it with this and absolutely no issues at all. Some of the pictures have even been published very recently. You know, and in terms of skin tone, in terms of different modes of lighting, the movement, you know, she kept moving a lot, Urvashi, when we were shooting. And just pause it there. Let's go back. Yeah, this one. So she kept moving a lot, and, you know, we had a lot of movement, lots of action, lots of full length, mid shots, full, you know, kept zooming in and out, walking front and back. But the focus speed was incredible. I mean, you know, when we are shooting with flashlights, our modeling lamps are not very bright. You know, with that also, the focus was incredible. When you look through the electronic viewfinder, I think it's the best that I've seen. You know, so we kept upgrading our cameras all these years for one new feature that used to come. You know, say, okay, this camera's got more megapixel, let's buy this. When you know, okay, this camera's got this one new feature, let's buy it. But all the medium formats, I've, you know, tried a lot of cameras. I've owned a lot of equipment and kept upgrading with time. Didn't have eyeball focus. It didn't have, you know, the complete focus on the whole viewfinder. I've never seen that before. And it works immaculately, you know, in real shooting, especially when you're shooting with actors and models. I prefer shooting handheld. I rarely put my camera on a tripod. And this gave me complete freedom to do that. You can move to the next. So now even the dynamic range, you know, from the shadow detail in that picture especially, you can see these, it was completely like a silver windsheater that he was wearing. I could manage to get all the highlights, all the shadows within that one frame itself. I didn't have to do much post-processing. So I really, really enjoyed, you know, working with this, and I'm looking forward to explore a lot more features. The camera is packed with features. I mean to say, I've not even explored everything. You know, every time we do a shoot, I think we learn something more about the camera. It's a great experience. I'm very, very excited, you know, and I guess you all should all give it a try and, you know, get a feel of the camera, because for anyone who's shooting people, who's shooting fashion, even, you know, enthusiasts who are shooting landscapes, it's a great rugged built, you know, long-lasting battery. Even the vertical grip was very good when we were using all this. So, I mean, there's so much to talk about it, but nothing like, you know, feeling it and touching it. I'm very, very excited, you know, at the whole build quality. I think when even your model or your actor sees you holding this camera, they say, oh, wow, it's a good-looking camera, you know. So that also makes me feel good. So for me, I'm very, very excited. Guys, definitely watch out for this one. Yeah. All the best.
Check. Check. Thank you, sir, for sharing your experience with all of us. It's time now to meet the other photographer who's come all the way to India to share his experience with all of us. Please put your hands together for US-based leading editorial and commercial photographer and now a GFX global brand ambassador, Mr. Zack Arias.
Check, 1, 2, 3, here we are. Namaste. Thank you very much, everyone, for having me. I've got to keep this short and sweet. I want to talk today about why medium format matters. And I have a very special first announcement from Fujifilm at the end of this, sort of, kind of. So I have been a photographer for over 20 years now. I grew up in the film days, right? We're old friends in that, the four-letter F word, film. And back in those days, if you were a professional photographer, you shot medium format and up, especially for commercial work, editorial work. 35 millimeter was reserved for amateurs like my dad, who got me into photography. Newspaper, photojournalism, you know, that kind of thing. But even wedding photographers, do we have any wedding photographers that used to shoot Hasselblad at weddings? Anyone want to show their age? I remember assisting photographers who shot Hasselblad film cameras at weddings, right? So medium format ruled the day. And really, medium format was still a small format. A lot of people shot 4x5, 8x10. When digital came around, it was all based on a 35 millimeter kind of system. And we just accepted that as that is now our format. So all of us medium format shooters moved to 35 millimeter based cameras. I started back off with Nikon, back at the Nikon D100, went on through the D3. Then I switched to Canon because of Vincent Laferay, and we were all supposed to become, you know, great filmmakers because of the 5D Mark II. So I was with the 5D Mark II through the 3 before I got myself a little Fuji camera, fell in love with the X series, and like you were saying, the DSLRs just started to gather dust, and I started shooting with the X series. But everyone was like, but it's a smaller camera, a smaller sensor. True, but I was at a gallery showing about 8 years ago, 8 or 9 years ago, and there were several photographers showing work. And I think it was like 6 or 7 photographers. They all had their work up in a gallery, and it was all beautiful, beautiful work. But there was one photographer's work in particular that from across the room, I looked at his prints, and I could tell that they were different. I walked up to the prints. I stood this far away from them, and I just wanted to touch them. The detail, the color, just the tones of the picture. How, not just the focus falling off to the background, but how the focus fell off to the background. And the photographer's name, is a guy from the UK, shoots a lot of fashion. His name is Drew Gardner. And he's standing there, and I'm like, Drew, there's something about your prints. There's something about your images that stand out from everybody else here. And he just looked at me, and he said, medium format, mate, medium format. And I was like, shit, you know, I've got to go medium format. Well, it took me 3 years, and I could finally save up enough money to buy my first Phase 1 kit. I bought a Phase 1 IQ-140. I shot that kit for about 4 years or so. And then in the last few years, I upgraded it to the 100 megapixel XF system at a very substantial cost. And I went in to upgrade to 50 megapixels because 100 megapixels is absolutely ridiculous. Like, that is a stupid amount of data. I did not need 100 megapixels. I did not want 100 megapixels. But the very good salesman and dealer that I work with in the States said, Zack, I know you want the 50. Take the 100 for a week. If you don't like it, bring it back. We'll give you the 50. And I was like, I'll be here in a week. Like, just give me the 50 now. No. Just, it's on us. Take it, try it, and then bring it back. We'll give you the 50. I'm like, okay, I'll see you in 1 week. The next day I called him and said, I'll take the 100. I'll go, I'm keeping it. Like, it is ridiculous, but it's fantastic. What is amazing in medium format that you don't get in smaller formats is the details and the dynamic range. I say the devil is in the details. I'm not a big pixel peeper. I never read DXO marks on anything. I don't really like track all of that stuff. But when you're shooting 100 megapixels, you can't help but do a little bit of pixel peeping. Because when you're shooting something that has a lot of detail or a lot of things going on, and you want to make big prints of it, you just want to go in and keep looking at all of the details to get lost in it. And with 100 megapixels, you can just keep going and going and going. It's insane. Let's go back. Right? And this is what I'm talking about. When you make a large print of this, you know, usually you make a large print based on how far away you're going to stand from it. Like, if you're standing 2.5 meters away, then you make a print this big and it will look fine, but the closer you get to it, the more and more it's going to degrade in quality. You can make a really big print and get right up on it and see all of that detail, every drop. I joke with my clients that I can extract their DNA from these photographs. There's so much detail. I could clone you from 100 megapixels. So this was shot with the GFX. I got the GFX and like 5 days later got on an airplane and headed over to this side of the world. I did not have very much time to shoot with it. And I'm going to remedy that as soon as this trip is done. But I was able to get like 1/116th of a shoot done with the GFX before leaving. And that detail is just stupendous. The dynamic range of medium format, though, is what is so important to me. And I'm going to show you, as me, as a professional photographer, very professional, how I screwed up on a photo shoot and how medium format saved me. So I shoot a lot of promotional stills and promotional campaigns for television shows in the United States. One of the people I work with a good bit is Vanilla Ice. Right? Everyone remember Vanilla Ice Ice Baby? He has a television show, and he's an awesome dude. So on promo and press days, what happens is there's going to be a film crew shooting all of the film promotional stuff they need for the television show, and then the stills guy. And it's usually just me. And video is going to take like 4 hours doing a shot, and then they yell, stills! And I come running up, and I get like 2 minutes, right? They get 4 hours. You're shaking your head. This is your life, right? You're sitting around getting fat over at craft services, just eating food until someone yells stills. And you run in, and you get 2 minutes. So typically what I do to make the most of my time is while the video crew is setting up the shot, I jump in and take all of my test shots. I get my exposure set. I figure out which lens I'm going to use. I get my kind of like placement, like, okay, I'm going to shoot from here. I'm going to shoot with the 35 millimeter lens. I'm going to do this. I'm going to do that. All right, let me lock in my exposure. So when the talent is on set and they call me in, I just get my camera and I can go in and start shooting. And I can concentrate on getting the shot that I need because I have very little time. And then I yell stills out and I step back out and they go on to the next setup. So I get everything set up. I get all my exposure set and it's my turn. I told you I get all of my exposure set. What happened was, as I was getting set up, the sun was behind clouds. When it was my turn to shoot, the sun had come out. But I was so frantic in my head and like, I got to get in there, I got to start taking pictures, that I didn't even realize, hey, the light changed, my exposure should change, but I didn't. So I fire off 40 frames looking like that, right? He's wearing a white hat, and it's just bleeding off into the sky. So I shoot, I shoot, I shoot, I shoot. I'm like, okay, still's out. I step back. I start to look at my camera. And, oh, shit. And I can't go, oh, hey, everyone, I messed up. Can we do that again? You can't do that on a set. You can't do it. Art director's there. How'd it go? Let's take a look. Yeah, I'll show them to you in just a minute. Let me get them downloaded. I got a full card. Let me download them to the computer. I'll pull them up on the computer here in just a minute, and you can take a look at them. And I'm like sweating. But I was also okay because I shot it medium format. I'm like, it's totally fine. Totally fine. All right. So we go into capture one. You can see that, like, that from that white hat to the sky, we've lost nearly all the detail. It's fine. It's all there. Watch this. We're going to go pull up this in capture one here. Going to get my little exposure and highlight slider going here. We're all zeroed out. Bring that highlight back. Maybe bring that exposure down a bit. We can push those shadows back in a little bit. And when you're pushing highlights that much, when you're like doing that much of a push, the color will usually shift. In Capture One, it's pretty easy. Go into those highlights. And this is not a calibrated monitor by any stretch of the imagination, but you get the idea. You can go in, get that color back to where it needs to be, and check this out. Every bit of that detail is there. You can count the number of stitches in his hat. You can see each individual thread of the embroidery. What looked like it was completely blown is all still there. And then if you want more, if you want even more out of it, you can come in, bring it all down. So if you've completely blown something, or you're in a situation where the lighting is just so dramatic and so crazy, and you've got 14 stops of difference of stuff happening, you can capture one frame, go in, and develop it three ways if you need to. You can go in and get all the highlights, go get all the shadows, get everything, and then just mask that where you need to be. So, I mean, it's unbelievable how much you can just stomp up and down on a medium format file, and it holds together. I'll show another example. So this was literally on my way to the airport to fly here on this multi-city tour that I'm on. And this was a guy named Zoe. He actually lived near the airport. And I'm like, look, I need some sample photos. I'm doing a talk about this camera. I'm getting on an airplane. Can I stop by your house? Can we do a quick shoot? Like, can I just get a couple pictures? And he's like, absolutely. It was either Zoe or my cat. So I'd either stand up here showing you pictures of people, or I'd be showing you a picture of my cat, right? Because it was such a quick turnaround of getting the new camera. So I'm taking pictures of Zoe here. I've got my flash set up. I'm taking some test shots. I'm wanting to get some pixel peeping, zooming in kind of pictures. And then my flash stops firing, right? Flash fires, and then the flash doesn't fire. And I thought, hey, this will actually be a good test of the shadow dynamic range. So I'm going to push this over 3.5 stops of light to bring all of that shadow detail back. Normally, if you pushed an image this much, yeah, you could kind of bring it back, but it's gonna be so filled with noise, there's gonna be so many, like, just choppy gradients, it's gonna be so ugly. I'm gonna zoom in here, I'm gonna give it a second to kind of load and pull its full preview up, and there it goes. And it is, as we say in the South, clean as a whistle. It is so clean. There's no noise. This, notwithstanding this monitor screen here, which is pretty pixelated. This isn't made for 100 megapixels. All the detail is in the shadows. All the detail is there in the highlights. We can bring that back down. This is straight from camera. Zero everything out. You can have it so completely underexposed and bring it right back. It's unbelievable. And all of the detail is there. I threw them out in the sun just so I could check the dynamic range on the highlights. I overexposed him just standing out in that bright sun. I wanted to see how much I could bring back from the dead, and I could bring back everything I possibly needed. But you say, we want full frame. When I moved to Fuji X series, I was like, I am in love with this. I dropped from full frame 35 millimeter to APS-C. And people looked at me like I was insane. And I was like, look, I took some pictures with my Fuji cameras. I took some pictures with my Canon cameras. I made some prints. I put them on the wall. I stepped back and looked at them. And the difference was so negligible that not one thing stood out from the other. Medium format prints, well, those, yeah, that stands out. But between full frame and APS-C with these new sensors and with Fuji, it's, and I like shooting the Fuji camera, and I enjoy it, and the lenses are great. And, you know, but everyone tells me, well, if Fuji would just make a full frame camera, if they'd make a full frame camera, I'd consider going to Fuji. But that APS-C is too small. I want full frame. I am here to announce today that Fujifilm has developed a full-frame mirrorless camera. It's called the GFX. All right? So here's what happens. People say, well, I want a full frame from Fuji. Okay, they made one. It's called GFX. No. I want 35 millimeter full frame. Oh, so you want a small sensor? No. I want a large sensor. Oh, okay, GFX. No. No, we want full frame. Oh, you want a small sensor? No, we want a large sensor. Large sensor. No. We don't want large, we want a small, wait, I want a small sensor. Oh, no, I want a small sensor. 35 millimeter, small sensor. GFX, large sensor, all right? Now then, I own the Phase 1, and it's a beast of a camera. It's heavy. It 95% of the time lives on a tripod. With medium format, your depth of field can be so shallow that focus is critical. So typically how I shoot my Phase 1 is it's locked down on a tripod. I then put my subject on a tripod. It's very uncomfortable for them. And nothing can move. I go into live view, I punch into 100%, I manually focus, I take my picture. It's a very slow process. It does autofocus, but it has one big fat autofocus point right in the middle. You can't move it, it doesn't go anywhere. If you like focus and recompose, you have to be very careful. Anything under 5.6, you're gonna blow your focus out. So it's a very slow camera to work with. I call the GFX medium format to go, okay? The GFX is the same size as any Canon or Nikon DSLR. If you're used to shooting a DSLR with a battery grip, then you're already used to shooting a GFX. If you shoot a 5D Mark, whatever, if you shoot a Nikon, you know, 6D, C3PO R2-D2 camera, if it's got a vertical grip and a decent pro lens on it, like a 24-70 2.8, you're already used to shooting with a GFX, all right? So my Phase 1 system, it's a beautiful camera, but it's huge, it's heavy, it has single autofocus point, no image stabilization, raw only. If you need a very fast workflow, like super quick to show clients, and you're working with 100 megapixel raw files, it's super nice to also have a JPEG on the side. You can run through the JPEGs real quick and then flag your raws. There's no Wi-Fi image transfer. $50,000 US just for the body and the back. That's no lenses. And it's too expensive to have a backup. The backup to my Phase 1 is my Fujifilm X-Pro2, okay? The Fujifilm GFX 100, DSLR size, easy, super easy to handhold. 3.7 million phase detection autofocus points, image stabilization, RAW plus JPEG, Wi-Fi image transfer, only 10,000 USD. But when you're looking at a 50,000 USD equivalent, you could have 5 GFXs for the price of one phase one. You could buy a GFX, a GFXR as a backup, and like pretty much all the lenses and still have chai money left over, all right? You could have the whole bag, the whole kit and caboodle, and maybe even buy an Instax printer for $50,000 US. And you have two cameras, multiple lenses, and chai money, all right? If this doesn't go on the internet, I might be going home and selling my phase one to buy the GFX100, but don't put that on the internet yet. But anyways, that is why medium format matters. I highly, highly encourage you to go through the gallery, into the touch and try space, and get your hands on one, play with it, pixel peep all you want, get in there 100% and see who needs to cut their nose hairs or not, because you'll see all of that. All right, thank you very much, everyone.
Check, check. Thank you very much, Zack. I think that was a very, very interesting, a very well-explained experience sharing that you have just done with us right now. So we've just spoken about the Fujifilm GFX100, but it's time now to talk about the Premista lenses. We don't have the gentleman present here, but what he has done for us is that he has created a beautiful short film on the Fuji non-Premista lenses. And I'm going to be showing you the AV right now. It is being presented by acclaimed cinematographer and DOP, Mr. Palash Sen. Can we have the AV on screen, please?
Hi, myself Palash. I am a DOP from India. Recently, I've been honored to test shoot the Fuji non-Premista lens and make a beautiful ad film with it. The lens is a breakthrough for the cinema. Hi, myself Palash. I am a DOP from India. Recently, I've been honored to test shoot the Fuji non-Premista lens and make a beautiful ad film with it. The lens is a breakthrough for the cine zoom lenses with crisper image and proper focal length coverage throughout the zoom range. The lens has beautiful flares to it and the bokeh effect is quite beautiful as well. Overall experience with the lens has been nothing but fantastic, and I would recommend it to DOPs around the world to use the Fuji non-zoom lens. Hi, myself.
So ladies and gentlemen, that was the Premista lens for all of you. It's time now for a Q&A round. I'm going to re-invite my management team on stage. Anybody has a question, I'm going to request you to kindly do a show of hands. We will pass on the mics. Also, I would like to mention that at 4 o'clock today, Mr. Zack is going to be conducting a workshop. So we would like to invite all of you sitting in the audience to attend that. There's going to be a photography workshop, which is going to happen at 4 p.m. right here in this room. So those of you who want to attend it, please ensure that you stay back. You can register with us. All right, gentlemen, can I have you all on stage, please? I request Toshi-san, Iwata-san, Makoto-san, Ram-san, and Arun-san to join us.
Okay, before the question comes, let me announce the price for the products launched today. GFX100, the Indian MRP price is 7,86,999 for the body. Okay, that is the price actually. So this we have taken into account is one of the most attractive price on the product category like this actually. As far as the Premista lens for the 2800, the Indian price will be, MRP will be 31,99,000. For 80 250 mm, the price will be 32,99,000. Thank you. Any questions the media would like to put? Can we pass the mic there?
Hi, we do a lot of video work. My name is Tejas. a consistent fear when you take a high megapixel camera is the low light capabilities. You would like to share something about that?
Low light capability.
Yeah.
Became already the history. Please touch on the GFX 100, the later on, right? So you will the completely different feeling. The low light autofocus and the low light ISO sensitivities, I will guarantee you will be satisfied.
Thank you.
Because you know that's a new sensor you saw on the backside and the copper wiring and the powerful processors, it's already guaranteed. Minus 2.0 EV, it perfectly works. Autofocus.
Another fear we have is the yellow and the jitter when we shoot video on the DSLRs and the mirrorless cameras. The fear that we have when we shoot video on these cameras is the yellow and the jitter when there's a lot of movement of the subject for shooting video.
I think you asking about the low light capability about the video.
That was one question. The second question was low light and jitter. Jitter and yellow effect.
Lowering.
So I didn't see any image out there which had a fast pan.
Fast question. Yeah. So can you imagine the 4K video from 100 megapixel? It should be nice noise, right? So we made the 4K video by over 60 megapixel. So that's good enough against the noise. And about the loading speed, actually, so our 4K is up to 30 FPS, but a bit higher speed about the loading speed, like 1/34 or something like that.
Okay, thank you.
If no more questions are there, then we will move on to the, yeah, there's a gentleman. There's a gentleman.
3.76 million micrometer.
Yeah, it's answered. Okay, if some of the technical magazines who want further more technical details, we have arranged a detailed session further. You can put on your detailed questions. That will be, our team will guide you to the next room. And here only. And for the rest of them, we can move for the hands-on and further experience, actually. Yeah.
Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining me on stage and doing the honors. Request you all to take your seats. Thank you very much once again to all of you for joining us here today. As sir mentioned, the image gallery is on this side to your right. The entry is from this door. Any further questions that you may have, my management is going to be available. So more questions can be taken offline. We have a section behind which has been created for corporate bites. So anybody has any questions that you would like to ask us, that is the section where you can join us and ask the questions. Image gallery is this side. The technical session will commence now in this ballroom and it's going to be conducted by Makoto-san. And last but not the least, I'm going to once again request those of you who are going to be uploading content on social media, don't forget to tag us with @FujifilmXIndia and #Revolution100. Thank you very much once again for being a part of this grand occasion.